Now, sports from the First National Bank Sports Desk. First National Bank of North Platte, the bank to think of first.
Well, the time has just about arrived. A shot at a championship is on the line tomorrow night. Scottsbluff and Roncali. One might say that's all that needs to be said. In a way, that's true. But also, there's plenty that needs to be talked about and covered leading up to what could be an epic state semifinal game in Class B tomorrow night in Omaha. Of course, last year's game in the quarterfinals had all the storylines, early turnovers from Scottsbluff, Jack Dotzler and the Pride racing out to the big lead, then the Dotzler injury, and then the monster comeback that resulted in a 62-36 blowout win for the Bearcats. For Scottsbluff this time around, it's a long trip east with a shot to play in the state title game hanging in the balance. Let's start with Cats head coach Judd Hall, who saw his team roll up over 450 yards rushing last week against Norris.
And I think you have to be able to run the football in the playoffs to win. I think if you look at the state championship teams every year, they're teams that have to run the ball and be able to control the clock and change field position with the run game. I think we're built for that. I think we're very good at that, so we're going to see what happens on Friday night.
This game will be more than about two players. That's obvious, and the outcome probably comes down to all the other pieces on both rosters. But the quarterback matchup is one of the best imaginable. Scottsbluff's Sebastian Harsh and Roncalli's Jack Dotzler. Harsh last week, well, he ran 43 times for 275 yards and 5 touchdowns. And he got serious when I asked him about this showdown with Dotzler.
It's definitely a chip that I want to put on my shoulder to just show out and make sure that I'm one of the top dudes on the field after the game.
The force of nature in Sebastian Harsh and the dual threat acrobatics of Roncalli's Jack Dotzler. Scottsbluff D coordinator Jake McClain knows his guys need to be on point.
Executing the call and making sure everyone's in their right lane is going to be a big deal because, you know, you leave a crease, he'll find it. He's that good and that special of a player.
So far this year for Dotzler, nearly 3,000 yards passing with 35 touchdowns. Also, over 500 on the ground with another 11 touchdowns rushing. Those two will play great. We know that. This one, though, much like last week, feels like it's going to be decided in the trenches on both sides of the football. That's good news for Scottsbluff since they have 6'6 tackle Sam Clarkson opening up holes. Clarkson made the big decision last week to commit to Division II power, Northwest Missouri State.
I'm very excited. Really an easy choice. Great winning culture, and it doesn't hurt having big brother there, obviously, and I'm just really excited to get started.
Older brother Austin, a starting O lineman at Northwest right now. The two will have 1 year together on campus. You've got to figure this game tomorrow night features a lot of scoring. Coach McClain knows Roncalli's going to make some plays and find the end zone a few times. So it'll be about some key stops, maybe a turnover, things like that.
We're just going to try and roll with it, hopefully get some pressure, and hopefully make some key plays down the stretch.
Scottsbluff just has so many really good high school football players. They're well coached and they're hungry. It's a great recipe as the head coach looks for another big time effort tomorrow.
I think we just got to stay disciplined in our game plans. I think our kids are really buying into what we're trying to accomplish as a coaching staff right now. They're feeding off each other and then feeding off what we're trying to do as a team. So I think just go out and execute what we've been working on in practice and see what that does for us on Friday night.
We'd sure love to have you tune in tomorrow for our radio-only broadcast on 106.9 The Trail and KNEB.com. We'll get things started with pregame at 4:30, kickoff at 5 o'clock Mountain Time. Winner to play either Scott or Waverly in the Class B state title game. There, I'll say it now. Scottsbluff, Roncalli, enough said.